know who's been causing all the fuss. Tilda's little pet.
Silence. Zenith, inbound. Can we drop their shields, please?
I'm powering it up.
Stay still. This is pointless. You can't hurt us. Face it. You're worms that ooze through the cracks into our basement.
Silence?
One moment more.
But I might just spare you if you give up Tilda. I think it's safe to say she's forfeited her share of our operation. Permanently.
There.
No? Nothing. Fine. All right, people. Light 'em up! Are we supposed to be scared?
It won't take long before he preps the shuttle for launch. Then he'll be able to take Beta and Gaia into orbit and onto the Odyssey beyond our reach.
We gotta go through there?
I fail to see another option.
Then we'll carve a path. Ready?
Stop, Gerard.
I gotta get to the top of the tower and free Beta. Trust me, you're gonna wish you had one.
You wanted to fight, didn't you?
Whoa! You can't let it catch me.
There's nowhere to hide.
I'm taking you down!
Oh.
frustration. Adulation.
Not much without your shield, are ya?
Did you feel that? Hit me!
You're done for!
I wish I could bring you with me.
Sister. I'll lead group with the others and make sure they're all right. Looks like the machine's inspectors have almost wiped each other out.
What was that?
Aloy, Gerard just activated the self-destruct failsafe on the printing matrix. He's taking control of Unworth's systems.
Including the lift?
I'm afraid so. He's restricted its access to the top. He'll have to climb from there. I have to go. I almost have.
Mostly. We're cleaning up the last few specters.
What about the Xenos?
Dead, I think.
Machines and specters have almost wiped each other out. What was that?
Aloy, Gerard just activated the self-destruct failsafe on the printing matrix. He's taking control of a number of systems.
Including the lift?
I'm afraid so. He's restricted its access to the top. He'll have to climb from there. I have to go. I almost have.
Dead, I think. Izo told me you got Eric. Good work.
Yeah. Thanks. I guess only Tilda and Gerard are left then.
Aloy, you there? Listen, I got into the network, but only for a minute before I was shut out. I found a bunch of flight plans and trajectories, as if the Xenos were planning to leave Earth.
Doesn't make any sense.
I know. But there's more. The files I found have a lot of references to something called Nemesis. Whatever it is, the Xenos are afraid of it.
Alva? Alva!
What's going on here?
Maybe Beta can help me figure it out. She's okay. Are you okay? Look, I know you've been through a lot, but you have to help me access the Xenos network. I need to see their files. Anything referring to the word Nemesis. Okay. Over there. The systems are down all over the base. I should be able to take advantage of... Yes, Nemesis. Here. There's something in deep space. It's following the Xenos to Earth. Look. escape vectors. Alva tried to warn me about this. The Zeniths aren't planning to stay here.
It's a machine of some kind.
Or a swarm of them. The energy readings are
astronomical. Aloy, I don't think a natural disaster destroyed the Zenith colony on Sirius. This thing did.
Earth isn't a new home for them. It's a way station. They're on the run.
I see you've been busy.
And you've been lying. Nemesis, what is it?
It is us. The minds of Far Zenith. Or failed copies of them, anyway. Back on Sirius, some of my peers weren't satisfied with physical immortality. They wanted digital transcendence. A way to upload their minds into any form, organic or mechanical. Nemesis was a failed experiment to that effect. Abandoned, but never erased. An immense database of our memories, emotions, and prejudices left to fester.
And it destroyed your colony?
We didn't realize it had gained sentience until it broke containment. It had everything it needed from our memories. Security protocols, system specs, override codes. It hacked everything before we knew what hit us. Then it took over our printing facilities, allowing it to gain any machine form it needed to wipe us out.
But why?
Imagine being trapped alone for decades with only the twisted echoes of megalomaniacs for company. It hates us for abandoning it to that prison. And now that it's free, it will do anything to destroy us, including denying us a safe harbor on Earth.
The extinction signal that woke Hades. You didn't send it. Nemesis did.
Finally, you understand. And when that failed, it launched from Sirius to finish the job itself, which is why we must flee to a random planet circling a random star somewhere it can never find.
With Gaia, so you can build yourself a new world.
That's the plan. Even now. Earth is finished, Aloy. Nemesis will scour it of life to deny its creators a viable home. But Elizabeth's dream won't die. You'll come with me to the stars. And with Gaia, we'll create a new world. Together. Where that monstrosity could never find us.
What? No.
I loved Elizabeth. More than you could ever know. And I let her stay behind to die with the rest of humanity. A mistake I have regretted for a thousand. Now she stands before me again. Not some inferior copy. But her best possible self. So I'm not asking. You're coming with me. It may seem harsh now, but you'll forgive me in a few centuries.
You can't force me, Tilda. Your shield is gone.
I have something better. Spectre Prime, to me.
Get to the
door! Submit, Aloy. Can't wait. No! I've heard that before.
This Spectre was designed to survive against more than that.
I better scan that thing first.
Thank you. murder me.
Do some damage.
I can endure. You cannot.
Tilda!
This Spectre was designed to survive against more than that.
Thank you.
as she tried to take you. And she told you about Nemesis.
So you've known all along.
From Hades, yes. Along with data on how to circumvent the Zenith shields. Everything I did to create the Rebel Army was based on that knowledge. To reach this place, this moment.
And you couldn't just tell me?
Come now, Aloy. You're the last person to act sensibly in the face of impossible odds. When I learned of Nemesis from Hades, I saw the pieces on the board and how to play them. And in that same moment, I knew it was a game you would never play. That you would interfere and attempt to save the Tenakt. I was correct, to a point. You ruined my plans, but brought your own to fruition. The end result is the same. We're here. And now it's time for me to leave this doomed planet behind. To seize the Odyssey and the Apollo database and begin a new chapter in my pursuit of knowledge, one with infinite possibilities. You can join me if you so desire. You've more than earned your place. Unlike Tilda, I'm extending a polite invitation.
You're going to just take off and abandon everything? Stay. Help me fight that thing.
Perhaps Tilda didn't adequately define the threat. Nemesis can't be stopped. It destroyed a highly advanced Zenith colony in a matter of hours. What hope does this primitive tribal Earth have? If you brought Gaia, you wouldn't be abandoning life. You'd be saving a seed for a new world. Just as Elizabeth did. It's the choice she made. The sacrifice of all that is for the hope of what might be. If she were here in your place, she would board that shuttle, Aloy.
Found her.
Is she hurt?
Still on her feet.
Thank the Ten.
Goodbye, Silence.
She looks okay.
She looks victorious.
As always.
Aloy. You did it.
Where's he going?
As far away as anyone can go.
Oh. Are you sure?
You're staying.
For a time. You people are going to need all of the help you can get.
Does anyone else need a drink?
Not if it's that ale of yours.
I'd be fine with a nap.
Excellent idea.
I hope it's really over this time.
There's another battle ahead, Elizabeth. Very different than the one you fought. It's not about the distant hope of creating a new world.
preserving the one we have. My friends have a new mission. To spread the word and ask for help. They've taken it in stride. I think it's because they've always known what I've only just started to understand. That the people of this world have the strength to fight any battle. The ingenuity to solve any problem. And the resilience to rise after any setback. As for me, I can't say I'm not afraid. What lies ahead will be harder than anything we've faced before. First time in my life, I feel like I'm not alone.
Has grown so somber. These words don't seem like mine, but the iron won't subside. No matter, no matter what I try. My raindrops in the path we lost. Am I raindrops in the flood? In this emptiness, in the storm. If I'm broken, if I'm torn, the wave inside my pots are full of flowers.
What are you up to?
I'm getting a head start on looking for ways to temporarily stabilize the biosphere. We may not have Hephaestus, but I'm sure we can come up with something.
I'm surprised you're staying in the base. Slink away to one of your workshops.
The capabilities of this facility are adequate for now.
Well, make yourself at home, I guess. Plugging in that power cell downstairs must have turned on these holograms. We didn't fall. We stopped the Zenus. We saved life on Earth. Well, for now, at least. There's another threat coming. I don't know how we're gonna beat it. But we'll face it together. All of us. Rest easy, my friend. I'll visit again when I can. Snow's melting on my clothes. Great. Everything okay, Gaia?
Yes, it is good to be home. Although my heuristic matrix will take some time to reinitialize. I must ensure that all Zenith code has been purged from my systems.
Good idea. Take as long as you need. Are we going to be able to fix the biosphere? With Hephaestus back out in the wild?
With its escape to the Global Cauldron Network, Hephaestus has resumed its operations and increased its security protocols. I am already formulating options to recontain it. Additionally, I will utilize the capabilities of my remaining subordinate functions and make every effort to stave off collapse of the biosphere. I am certain we'll gain us some time.
Sounds good.
Reinitialization in progress. I will inform you when it is complete.